Hi, I'm Jack Buck. You're just in time. In time for what? Top Star Bowling, right inside here at the Marlboro Lanes. Come on, join us, will you? Well, it's another week here on Top Star Bowling in a very familiar setting as we're here at the Marlboro Lanes in the village of Marlboro, just southwest of the city of St. Louis, the gateway to the west. Jack Buck welcoming you along with Whitey Harris, and it's our pleasure to introduce the participants on this week's edition of the show. Before you meet them, and one of them is a very familiar figure, having won the past 3 weeks, let me tell you about the format. It's the King of the Hill format. The winner stays on, wins $1,000, the loser collects $500. It's a three-game match, total pins count, and additional prize money is available. And in fact, the front runner is with us today for the high series and the high game in a 13-week period. I'm talking about Ray Bluth, whom you'll be meeting in just a moment, and that prize money is the King Louis Shirt Award. I've already referred to him, so let's bring him up. He's been murdering these lanes. He's won the past 3 weeks. Former Masters champion from the St. Louis area, Ray Bluth. You're piling up the big money, but you can't knock down on the expenses. You only live around the corner.
That's for sure, but I enjoy being home for a change.
And a wonderful fellow to oppose you today.
Well, he's talking nice to me so far, but once the competition starts, he won't be so nice.
We're talking about a gentleman who's from Detroit. His name is Bill Srock, and he is an author of a book on bowling, Fundamentals of Bowling. He is a teaching specialist within the Brunswick ranks and specializes further with junior bowling. By the way, a former outstanding softball pitcher. I don't know if the two sports are really related. Maybe we'll find out when we welcome Bill Srock. Bill? Nice to have you here.
Pleasure to be here,
Jay. We didn't have you last year on Top Star Bowling, did we?
No, sir, I didn't have the opportunity to appear.
What about that little reference that I made to softball and bowling? Are they intertwined or not?
No, I don't think so. I had to set aside the softball. It interfered considerably.
Uh-huh. Well, we hope that you've gotten it out of your system completely to the point where you can compete well with Ray Bluth, and we'll let you get down there to get started.
We hope so. Good luck, Ray.
Bill Srock and Ray Bluth. Three games, total pins, $1,000, Top Star Bowling. Ray Bluth won the toss. And he is starting on lane 21. Ray has shown us some great bowling during the past 3 weeks, just shy of the 700 mark, as he won for the second time. And he's on 21 and fails to carry the 7-pin here in the first frame. Now he'll be shooting for the spare. And as he does so, let me introduce to the microphone Jerome Whitey Harris, a member of the Brunswick advisory staff of champions. The fellow's done a good deal of world traveling on behalf of bowling, and you'll be hearing from Whitey in just a moment. Right now, Ray Bluth shooting cross lane, going for the 7-pin. And he moves to start his game. Now, Bill Srock. I haven't had the pleasure of meeting this gentleman prior to this get-together.
Jack, Bill has done not only a lot of work in the States here, and you mentioned my traveling, he's been involved with our international division quite a bit, too. He is well qualified as an instructor, and he does have bowling ability.
He played away outside, failed to get to the head pin, and he leaves the 1-2-8 here in his first delivery. Why do you have to be an outstanding bowler in order to instruct? Does it follow?
I think the pattern is changing because in the Brunswick advisory staff, it's part of the requirements of our bowlers that they do have a fairly good knowledge of the game so that they can go out and instruct.
And so he matches Ray Bluth as he marks in the first frame. Three games, $1,000 in this ABC-sanctioned event. Top Star Bowling is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress. Lanes is certified by ABC and checked prior to each match each week. Who's going to get the first strike? On the nose, a getaway, 7-pin drop, 6-10 remains.
Bill, for his size, actually has a nice, easy motion, Jack, if you notice, and he also takes 5 steps, and he's he's in between the 12 and 15-foot dots, which are back on the approach.
He has quite a few titles in and around his home city and state, Detroit, Michigan. He's right out there. Just watching him here in the early frames, Whitey, I think the biggest thing that the bowlers are going to learn, who are inclined to learn from watching, will have to do with that follow-through of his in a way he's fully extended as he lets the ball go.
And I think we've got an example of both the good men who are stationary at the approach.
There's a Ray Bluth strike, the first strike of the game in the match.
By stationary approach, I'm in at the foul line, Jack, and then when we make a comment like that, you see what happened to Ray.
Ray defeated Steve Nagy with the 626 series, defeated Wayne Zahn with a 692, defeated Harry Smith with 675. He's there with a double. When he defeated Harry Smith last week, Ray had 23 strikes in the match. He has averaged 221 in the 9 games that he has bowled. So he has a spare and a double. Bill Srock has 2 spares. And the 4-pin. The best league average for Bill was 216. He's had 5 300-games. He's had a 769 series. Very impressive personality. Of course, he's going to have to impress Ray Bluth with something more than his personality. He's going for his 3rd mark. All of them spares. 37 through the 2nd frame with a spare up. Ray Bluth out in front in this 13-week period with a high series of 692.
Jack, you know that week after week, this lady who you said you were going to find out who it is sitting here again. Must be really interested in the game of bowling.
She won't talk to me. I don't know who she is. I can't find out.
I'm going to make it up my business during the week trying to
find... How does she always get that seat? There's a little collusion going on.
Well, you've heard of some of these producers and directors. I mean, you know, things go on like that. So I'm going to find out who she is. You can bet.
Bill Srock, trying to spare again. And he does. And so, Bill is yet to find the pocket sufficiently to carry the strike. Bill Srock better get to it. That's 3 in a row for Ray Bluth after starting with a spare.
Well, Jack, if you recall, last week you commented when Ray shot that 265 game that he might have had a pretty good game if he wouldn't have got a split. Sort of a revengeful person as Ray is. I think he's going to try to really prove to you he can bowl.
The picture of concentration. The lift and the follow-through, and the inexplicable 8-10.
You know, just like I explain things up here, and I do have the... I am called the Potter Familius of bowling.
What?
That means that I'm a sage, an oracle, and just there again it proves, because I called that he would get an 8-10.
There it is. The 8-pin, 10 left. There is his open, and a chance for Bill Srock to get back in. Bill in the 5th frame, working on a spare. We're in the first game here on Top Star Bowling, bowling for $1,000. Maybe. Yeah, there it is. That's his first strike. So Ray Bluth opened in the fifth. He has 106. Bill Srock has 72 through the fourth with a strike up. Going for a double. Yeah, he's there. I'll tell you one thing about these bowlers, and they learn to compete. It matters not the reputation of their adversary. They go out and hit, and they work on their own game, concentrate on getting their own strikes and their own high totals, and then let come what may come. Ray Bluth, after an open, trying to get back in, and he does. Were it not for that 8-10, which he well could have carried, Ray would have five in a row, but that's not the way it is. 106 through the fifth with a strike up. Seventh frame now. There's a double. So a three-bagger and a double. We've got a good one on our hands.
Jack, the Marlboro Lanes here have a what they call the gold crown masking units and tangerine color. What I'm working up to, this whole color decor is through the outfit, and the young lady that we're trying to find out who about, if this was in color, she's in a tangerine outfit today. So I'm getting pretty close on some clues.
Bill was going for three in a row. Got an eight count as he left the 2-5. That young lady's getting to you, huh?
Yes, I know everything about all our products, the Brunswick Company, and unless this is something new that's been introduced, I don't know.
Let's see if Bill Srock can continue to mark. He has no opens. Ray Bluth has one. There's his spare. Now around to the eighth frame. And Bill is well aware of the fact that Ray Bluth has a double going. He'd like to get on one right here.
Ray and Jack, in watching Bill, it goes right along with anyone that instructs, tries to get over to his pupils how to roll the ball. And you just note this, the way he stays up there.
He just put that ball down in the wrong spot.
Yeah.
Missed by plenty as he failed to get to the... head pin.
I keep constantly, you know, you hear voices, and if you recall, this is a strange thing. I thought he took five steps, and so just I counted him before, and he's a four-step bowler.
He covers that spare nicely. Lost on the pin count, however, as he only got six on the spare in the seventh. That was his eighth frame, and now Ray Bluth bowls in the eighth. He has five strikes in the game so far. He opened in the fifth. He has a double going. He could go on to a 256 game if he were to go all the way. You know, Whitey, not to play the role of the expert fire, I'm not, but I didn't expect a strike on that hit. He seemed to throw the ball harder than he's been throwing.
Well, you analyzed it correctly, Jack, and the position we're here right now is Ray stepped out of line to the left. This is what looked like he just let up on the ball a little bit.
He gets a spare. So Ray has 155 through the seventh with a spare up. 29-pin lead at this point. Despite the open, you've got to get the strikes, and Ray has five of them so far. Got a little double action over there. He missed the seven pin the first time, but got it the second time around. Now Bill Srock in the ninth. He's had but two strikes. He put them together in the fifth and sixth frames. This ninth frame, very important.
Bill stands just about center on the approach, Jack, so that means he's playing this lane straight away.
Put that ball down nicely, and he dived in a little high, and he leaves the 4-7.
Stands to the right, too, Jack. On any spares to the left, the pros will be to the right on the approach.
He doesn't quit when he's out there. He lets that ball roll all the way and stays with it. Stays at the approach.
He has one of the characteristics of a lot of Detroit bowlers that if they see they're going to get a strike, Jack, they start running back and sort of make a motion with their hands, like clapping. Some of our great bowlers from out of Detroit do the same thing.
He's in the roll-off now. And he gets one to start with. So he's going to stay with Ray Bluth pretty well. 174 through the ninth, 204 with two more strikes. It's a good spot for that. He hasn't opened. He has a 6-7 now.
Bill does something that's good for a lot of the bowlers. He looks down at his hand to see where his thumb is positioned.
He gets one of those, too. Bill ends with 193. Dad, have you taken your son bowling lately? It's a lot of fun. A lot of fathers and sons have helped to organize leagues. You can do the same thing. Get a few friends together, reserve lanes Saturday or Sunday, or some evening at your neighborhood bowling center. Be surprised how well the youngsters are. Ray was going for a double there, which he didn't get. Leaves a 2-4-5, so this is going to be pretty close. 193 for Bill Strzok.
Ray is standing almost on the center dot, Jack. Normally, a lot of these fellas have been shooting left center when they shoot the 2-4-5. I imagine Ray will throw directly at it.
And he spares. So Ray needs a 10 count for 215.
Beautiful.
Ray Bluth ends the first game with 215. So we've completed the first game of our three-game match. It's Ray Bluth out in front, 215, Bill Strzok, 193. We're set to go on our second game in Top Star Bowling. And by the way, if you've wondered about some of the young people you've seen in the audience, they are here from Lutheran High South, a high school in this area. We certainly hope they're enjoying the bowling and learning as we go along. Ray Bluth out in front in the number of strikes, but nonetheless pretty close match, as Ray has a 22-pin advantage. Two more games to go, however, and we'll see if Bill Strzok can catch him now. More Top Star Bowling. In the first game, each started with a spare. Now Bill Strzok gets us underway in the second game. He had but three strikes in the opener. Let's see if he can get off on one here. Hey, did a little thinking. Did a little thinking between games. Bill must bowl with a lot of teams, because as he came back, he said, come on, Ray, let's go. Either that or you're just rooting for some good competition.
No, right? I think this is a natural thing that you see a lot of these bowlers that bowl teams or either doubles, Jack. They get in the habit of doing that.
Well, he inspired his opponent. Each start with a strike.
Ray is continuing his mastery of the Marlboro Lanes, Jack. He's averaging about seven strikes a game.
No, Eddie, last year on Top Star Bowling, three victories was most anyone was able to accomplish. So Ray Bluth is going for the fourth time.
That was Hoffman Estates, Illinois, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. There's a double.
Sometimes you're almost afraid to get a strike when you're bowling against Ray Bluth for fear of what he'll come back and do to you. Which is not to belittle Bill Srock, but to be sure, Ray Bluth has one of the fine bowling names in the world today. Let's see if Bill can match him with a double. Whoops. Ball started to run on him a little too soon.
Check.
And he leaves a 4-6.
There we have the action again of the Brunswick automatic pin setter, in which if that pin is, or the machine, the automatic strikes the pin and knocks it down, ABC rule states that we must set it back up. And that's what that six pin was doing, was rocking.
So Bill goes for the one pin, and he'll have to get started again in the third frame. Bill Srock from Detroit, Michigan. He's written a book on bowling, Fundamentals of Bowling, and a bowling instruction slide film. Down the nose, and he gets his second split in a row, this one the 3-10.
Jack, you mentioned the book. In our audience today is Johnny Archibald. He's the bowling editor of the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, and he has quite a book on bowling, and you know what it applies to actually boys and girls. It's a very unusual book, because most bowling has been just for the general group of bowlers, but this is directed at the boys and girls.
Nice pick on the baby split. So he's back on a mark. It's a strike, a split, and a spare for Bill Srock, and Ray Bluth has started with two. Had the lead at the start of the second game, 215 to 193. Difference of 22 pins. He's in the groove. He's had a lot of strikes here at Marlborough. Wonder how long he's going to stay around. We've got a real dandy coming up next week. Glenn Allison. Another familiar name, and a fine bowler to watch.
By the way, that's spelled G-L-E-double-N. This has always been amongst the inner circle of the bowling and the Brunswick people. Glenn always wants us to be sure that we add that extra N.
And the tap stops him.
The strange thing that happened, this little story I was telling you outside of Ray leaving that 10 pin in regards to Glenn, actually on one of the shows one time, the shirt did not have the double N on it. He wouldn't bowl. We had to go out and get a shirt, put an N on it. And Glenn is not temperamental. I don't mean it to say anything against him by that. Just a peculiar habit.
There's a spare for Ray Bluth. So after three strikes in a row, spare on the floor. Starting right in the middle, as has been pointed out. Second arrow. Pocket hit. Strike. Now he needs another hit. He's dropped further behind in this one as a result of the open in the second frame. Which he needed. You know, you're never too old to bowl. Many neighborhood bowling centers are now supplementing the facilities of the school system, so really you're never too young to bowl either. A lot of physical education directors are offering bowling as a regular course or as intramural activity. Check on it for your youngsters. A little bit high, just about that high. Four pin. So that gives a further opportunity for Bill Srock when he comes up again. That takes care of the fifth frame for Ray Bluth. Bill Srock has 48 through the third, and he has a double working. Ray Bluth has 98 through the fourth with a spare up. Ray started with three strikes and two spares. Now we find Mr. Bluth on lane 21. Back in the groove. When he loses that pocket, it doesn't take him long to get back in.
We often point out, Jack, here, that it's so important that when you start on that approach that you know where it is. And these bowlers constantly look down there before they throw the ball.
Bill was looking for three. He didn't get it. As he left a four pin, he's closed the gap in this one somewhat as a result of the double. Made up for that open he had in the second frame. But he's still down, and he was 22 pins behind at the start of the second game. Now there's the spare for Bill. Bill Srock trying to dethrone Ray Bluth, who's won for the past 3 weeks. Pin. I thought he had the ball driving better than that on a thin hit. Evidently, the ball didn't have enough on it to get in there.
Well, they seem to be all playing the left lane, Jack. They're playing it pretty deep and going actually over that third arrow. And sometimes when that ball gets out there, he had good mixing action there. He almost carried that four and the five.
And Bill spares in the seventh. So Ray Bluth has 118 through the fifth with a strike. Bill Srock, 116 through the sixth with a spare up. We're nearing the close of the second game as Ray Bluth bowls in the seventh frame, looking for a double out in front by 43 pins over Bill Srock. Ray on 22. And that's the way he's been hitting them, holding that line. When he gets his strikes, they're usually right in that same spot. A lot of players scramble and come in on different angles and still score and get a lot of strikes in a lot of different fashions, but not Ray Bluth. He either gets them one way or not at all.
Concentration, as we look at him right now, Jack, going up to that foul line.
He knew he needed a little work with that one. Leaves the 2-8. So Ray had a double, was looking for three. His lead has zoomed to 52 pins. He's got to drive through and get that 8-pin back there. And he does. He almost failed to be in the right spot to drive through. And arched eyebrows as he comes back to the bench. Bill Srock has a spare working. Hey, four pin drop for him. 136 through the seventh with a strike up. That's his fourth strike of the game. He's had one double. Had one double in the first game. He could go on to a 226 right here. Ray Bluth has a potential of 246. Hey, maybe not. Leaves the head pin.
Bill's quite involved in our promotion department, and there was a good example of him trying to show the Brunswick score kings all over the place the way those two pins came forward.
And I'm coming back this way. And he got the head pin. On his first pitch, right, I guess he was just all messed up. His time and so forth just didn't get up there properly.
Probably, Jack, because as we've noted, and you have too, on that left lane, you've got to be so far inside, and when you're not, that's what's happened. You go right past that head pin on the right.
Ninth frame for Ray Bluth. He's about due for another strike. He had a spare up. He strikes in the ninth and goes into the 10th frame. He started with 215. The split held him down. And that was in the middle of a string of strikes, by the way. Now he could go on to 246.
That was an 810 too, Jack, which, like we've explained, is a very good hit.
This is his first delivery in the 10th frame. There he is, boy. He's something else again, this Bluth.
We've commented at different times because of Bill Bogey and Jim Moran, but looks like this fella here is going to be a partner of theirs, too, if he stays around here much longer.
This is his fourth week. He's got one strike in the 10th frame. That gives him three in a row. He started with three in a row, then two spares, then a double, and a spare. You remember he left that 2-8 in the 8th frame. Strike in the 9th, a double here in the 10th so far. Needs a hit here for 246 and 461, and he may show us that 700 this week. There it is. Bill Strock shakes his hand, congratulates him on the 246 game. 461 total for Ray. 239 is what he will need for 700 in our finale. He had 9 strikes in that game. He had 7 in the first game. Bill Schrock is in the roll-off. And he strikes. A lot of people rooting for Bill here. He needs 2 more for 206, in which event he would lose an additional 40 pins. He was 22 down at the end of the first game. And couldn't get it. 1-2-4-10. Has to cover these now for 196. Started with 192. Make it 193. Bill will want to hit on the Brooklyn side. He does. He covers it. Gets those pins, so after opening with 193, Bill Schrock comes back with 196, 389 total, and Ray Bluth has a total of 461 at the end of two games.
Very shortly, we'll be underway with our third and final game here on Top Star Bowling. A while ago, during the telecast, I referred to some young people who were in our audience. And they're from Lutheran High South, the high school in this area. And Don Edding, who is the physical education chairman of that school, is in our audience. Don, how about coming up and chat for a while, please? Don, good to see you.
Happy to meet you, Jack.
I know the bowling is a part of your program, but prior to that, basketball and baseball also your forte there.
Right. However, we are just initiating a bowling program into our physical education program over at Lutheran South right this present year. We will start this program right over here at Marlboro Lanes in February of next year.
There may not be any strikes left if Bluth keeps hitting them here. Could the young people apply this to their studies?
Oh, for sure.
And it helps with their mathematics.
Mathematics, science, physics, etc.
I've got a poor mathematician back there with me. Could you use Whitey Harris on your basketball team?
Yes, I believe we could use him if he'd lose a few pounds.
Hey, you know what happened? You reminded me. He stepped on a scale the other day, and a card came out with his weight and his fortune down, and it said one of you is going to take a trip. Well, listen, we got away from the subject, but you made the subject very plain to us, Don. Good luck with your bowling program at Lutheran South.
Thank you, Jack, and we hope he keeps throwing strikes.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
See you again. Don Edding, our guest here on Top Star Bowling, and the third game is coming up.
Ray Bluth gets the third game underway. This is his fourth consecutive appearance in Top Star Bowling. He starts this game with a 72-pin advantage. Will this be the week he hits that coveted 700 mark? Have to get the good start. No 5-pin, and that's a rarity for Mr. Bluth. Why do you don't see that very often with Ray bowling?
No, and I think he expected to carry that one, Jack, because he gives that motion with his right arm, which, you know, they try to help it along after the ball has left his hand.
Ray's total 461 for the two games. 215, 246. By the way, a point of interest, whenever the professionals do shoot that five pin, and it's not very often, they watch very carefully the path of the ball, their position at the foul line and apply that knowledge on their next throw for a strike. Bill Srock was way out, but the ball came up nicely for him. I think he was further out in that lane than he has been throughout, but he carried.
Started to move back, Jack. Maybe if he starts striking, he'll be really running.
Looking for a double. In there. Bill had three strikes in the first game. Came back with five in the second game. And he starts this one with a double. So maybe Ray Bluth will show us a 700 and Bill Srock will give us a 300 game, huh? Wouldn't that be something? You put a double up against Ray Bluth, it's like waving the red flag. Ray goes to work himself after starting with a spare. Ray defeated Steve Maggie, Wayne Zahn, Harry Smith, and he has Bill Srock in his grasp. He's on the head pin and almost got a 10 count nonetheless. Even the six pin, which remains, almost went down, so no double for Ray here. Ray's high series in his three prior appearances, 692. There's his spare. And we can all learn a lot by watching Ray and the way he goes after those spares, stays right with it, takes nothing for granted. He could have used that one for his third in a row. No seven pin. Bill Srock from Detroit, Michigan.
You know, these fellas like Bill, and of course, Ray has such a tremendous record and everything else. And this guy's such a nice guy. He even commented that sure he wants to win, but if he loses, he hopes he bowls well.
There's his spare. So he starts with a double and a spare and moves over to 21. Next week's newcomer will be Glenn Allison. A little fella. A rather unique bowling technique. He'll be fun to watch. He had a few people moaning when he let that ball go. He covered a lot of that lane to get that strike.
He really sent those pins flying.
Now he really feels bad about that seven pin back in the third frame. Well out in front. Nothing doing there. 2-5. Second time he left a five pin. Think he may be weary?
I don't think so, Jack. We've tried to analyze this thing time and again during Top Star Bowling, why these fellas go for a while in the pocket and then all of a sudden they're out of it for a few pitches. I don't know if there's a good solid answer for it or explanation.
Covered that nicely. And did he throw his regular strike ball to get that 2-5?
I think he would have probably used the same speed. He hasn't altered his speed. He probably moved a few boards to the left of that third arrow out there. We'll be able to watch now, actually, catching up. Ray will throw the ball on the third arrow on the left lane.
Ray Bluth is in the fifth frame.
And when he throws it on the third arrow, he misses the head pin. So I interpreted that correctly.
So he wants to be further inside than that?
I don't think so. I think here's how can we explain what's happened to this guy now? Two pitches in a row, he's actually throwing bad pitches. Before that, why, he was hitting the pocket solid. It must be something physically and mentally combined, Jack, where they lose that coordination.
Now, this is a spare that can be missed. But wasn't. Ray had one open in the first game, an 8-10 split. had a flawless mark in the second game as far as opens are concerned, and he is marked in all five frames in this game. Now, Bill Srock, who started with a double and a spare, has a strike up once again. He's ahead of Ray in this game. Leaves a 6-10. A few palpitations there as the seven pin glared at him for a while.
Jack, it was interesting, the interview with the gentleman from the Lutheran school. Actually, Bill Srock is involved in what Brunswick calls to the secondary school, these Brunswick Learn to Bowl kits. There's over 5,000 schools have been supplied these kits for learning.
There's his spare. And so Ray Bluth has 74 through the fourth with a spare up. Bill Srock has 89 through the fourth, likewise with a spare. Bill Srock in the sixth frame. Thin hit, 2-4-5.
We'll see where Bill stands on this one, Jack. He looks like he's studying it. He does stand a little left center to go right in line, probably aiming at that front pin.
Covered all three nicely. Ray Bluth up again. Ray's had only one strike in this game. He had seven in the first game and nine in the second game. Bill Srock has picked up 15 pins, but he's still rather far behind. You knew it wasn't going to be long before Ray found the range again. Back through the weeks, we had Bob Chase on hand for a couple of weeks. Joe Joseph, Don Ellis, both eliminated in a hurry. Steve Nagy won a couple. Ray Orff got knocked out. And then Bluth came along. And this is his fourth week, and that's why. A double for Ray. Bill started this game with a 389 total. Sure, he'd like to total 600 or more.
Jack, remember when Marion Ladwig was on the show? She does the same thing that Bill does when he looks down at the ball to see how his thumb is positioned. And this is the principle of pointing the thumb to where you're going to roll.
He had his thumb pointed wrong, I guess. Baby split, 310. He was looking for a double. He picked this earlier in our match. Moves to the left to throw a cross lane. And right by the three pin. I thought he was going to get it from where I was sitting. There's 154 through the eighth frame. Ray Bluth has two strikes going for him. He's in the eighth frame now. And back in the groove. We'll ask him later about how he lost the line here at the early part of this game. That's three in a row for him.
Well, Jackie has to go to work because we've commented about his averaging seven strikes. He's got four now, so he's only got four more tries to make it. So he's got
he
to
can still reach the 700, too. He's got to get them all, though, don't he, for 700. He'll come up in the 10th frame, needing three for 244 and 700.
He just needs
more than 700.
The way he's bowling, Jack, we just say he just needs doubles, and he's hitting the pocket that it does look like it's pretty easy.
This is the ninth frame. Srock. strikes again. Too bad about that split in the eighth frame. 214 if he can bang three of them home. And that'll put him over 600. On the nose, no break to 610. So the best he can do is spare here in the 10th. And bring him back for 10 for 194, and he'll be shy of the 300, of the 600 mark. Bill Srock from Detroit. He'll be number four on the list being compiled. There's his first miss. And he finishes with a nine count in the 10th frame in 182. 182 for Bill Srock, 571 total. Now let's see Ray Bluth. He has four in a row. He's in the 10th frame, trying to hit 700. Grinding them out, grinding them out. His previous high is 692, so he's got to keep hitting. 244 with two more hits. It'll be 705. So this is the one right here.
I'm not nervous, Eric. It doesn't bother me. I feel like he's going to get it, Jack.
It's the one he needs for 700. And he got the five pin down.
I guess you'll realize I'm an authority
after
and know
a while,
how these
I will.
Things
yeah,
go.
That's six in a row for him.
Yeah. It's also
now 705 with a 10 count.
It's also his seventh strike again, Jack. I'm sure he's over the 700 at this time.
And there he is. As he finishes with seven in a row, Ray Bluth. He had seven strikes, nine strikes, and eight strikes. 24 strikes in the match, and Ray Bluth wins it with a 705 total, 571 for Bill Srock.
Money, money time here on Top Star Bowling, and each week we have a young lady from the John Robert Powers School of Modeling and the Pat Allen Agency here in St. Louis to bring on the money. The young lady this week is Marge Monroe. Marge, how you doing?
Pretty
good
bad.
To see you.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Buck. It's nice to be here. Mr. Srock, this
thank
is
you.
Your check for $500.
Thank you very much.
And Mr. Bluth, this is your winning share of $1,000, and congratulations on your score of 705.
Thank you very much.
She knows all about it. Thank you very much, Mike. Thank you. This guy had 14 straight strikes, Bill, in the end of the third game and the time trials. And
you know what they say, there's only, you know, a good, smooth-running machine, there's only one way to stop it. Turn it off, but I don't know where the switch is. Somebody's got to find the switch or it's never going to stop running.
Maybe Glenn Allison next week, Ray.
He might, but I want to keep well-oiled. I mean... I'm going to bowl rather well next week, believe me. It's going to
Wait,
be a lot of practice.
Don't say anymore. We know what you meant.
All right.
We know what you meant. Next week will be your fifth appearance in Top Star Bowling. Glenn Allison will be the opponent for Ray Bluth. Ray, last week you almost gave us that 700, and you promised last week you'd give it a whirl this week, and you did.
I hope I can beat it next week now. Might need it.
Bill, you're a great guy, and it's been fun having you
Thank
here
you.
With us.
Real pleasure being here, Jack.
Bill Srock from Detroit and Ray Bluth. I've mentioned his name already, Glenn Allison. He's whipped Ray Bluth in a few other events. They've competed against each other quite often during the past few years. He'll be here on Top Star Bowling, and we'll be here at the Marlboro Lanes in the village of Marlboro, just outside the city of St. Louis, the gateway to the West. And speaking for Whitey Harris, congratulations to Ray Bluth. Tune us in next week, will you? And thanks for your time this time. Till next time, so long. Brunswick, the number one name in bowling. Top Star Bowling.
is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress.